Hello, lovely people. Welcome back to my channel. And if it's your first time, you are warmly welcome. And I hope you join this amazing family after watching the video till the end. Family, I do appreciate you all. And I thank you for your support and love. Today, we have another flavorful, delicious, crunchy spinach and kale stew. Family, I cannot wait to share my recipe with you. It's an amazing recipe and I hope you like it. Let's get started. Some of my ingredients are fennel seed, star anise seed, coriander seed, squat bonnet pepper, white and red onions, garlic, ginger, and I've also got here with me my chopped mushrooms, red and green bell peppers, homemade fermented fish or momoni, and my salted beef. They are all homemade. I'll leave the link below. If you haven't seen my video yet, check it out. It's so amazing. You'll love them. And I've got my 10 eggs, my white and red onions again, and my two chopped tomatoes. I've got more ingredients to show, so family, keep watching so you don't miss a step. Because I'm so sure after watching this video till the end, you'll not waste time trying this recipe out. You'll love it. It's amazing. I'm going to blend these basic aromatics. Set it on the side and then guys, we will continue from there. So keep watching and go nowhere. If it's your first time stumbling on this channel, hey, I hope you have been inspired. I'd love to have you here and you are warmly welcome. So please subscribe, click on the bell button to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. Okay, and to all my OGs, I do appreciate you a lot. Please keep sharing this video for others to see what I'm doing on this channel. Recommend this channel to friends and families to help build this amazing family together. Doing so will motivate your girl to bring you more amazing recipes. We are all done blending the aromatics, so I'll set that aside. And family, you start with the main job, okay? Our palm oil is melting hot. First, I'm going to put in my fermented fish. That is it. And again, I'll go ahead and add my salted beef or toro beef, okay? This will help build the flavor from the beginning because these are so amazing. And they always take your stews and soups to the next level. Wow, this is so beautiful. The aroma alone is so heavenly, guys. I'm loving this, and this is going to take my stew to the next level. Amazing. Keep watching and go nowhere. This recipe will blow your mind. I'm going to have to add my white and red onions as usual. Give it a gentle stir. We are going to keep stirring until the onion is golden brown or brown. At this point, make sure the heat is not too high. Even if it will be high, make sure to always keep an eye on it. Keep stirring it continuously and periodically. Wow, I love the aroma. Beautiful. Yeah, I think this color is okay. I love it this way. So I'm going to add my blended aromatics very soon. Here we go. Beautiful. What an amazing aroma. As usual, give it a gentle stir to combine everything nicely and beautifully together. We will then leave it for about 5 minutes for some of the water to dry out. And when that happens, guys, we will continue from there. So keep watching. And as you can clearly see, about 60% of the water is dried out. So I'm going to add my fresh chopped tomatoes. There you go. Beautiful. For some reason, I don't know why, but when I'm making my spinach stew or palava sauce, I hardly use tomato paste. I don't know why. I just want to only use the fresh tomatoes. Even though I've tried that before, I enjoy using the fresh tomatoes more. So family, you can always use your tomato paste and then you add your fresh chopped tomatoes. That is also awesome, but that's how I mostly love to make my spinach stew or consumer stew. I'm going to let it simmer for about 5 minutes and I'll add my eggs, okay? In goes the first egg, and I'm using 10 eggs for this recipe. You can use even less or more eggs, depending on how much eggs you want to have in the stew, or it will all depend on the quantity of Spanish stew or palava sauce you are making. At this stage, you want to let the heat remain on the medium level so that you can gently scramble the egg properly, okay? Don't let the heat be too much or else the egg will burn or even the stew will burn from the mutton. So make sure the heat is on the low to medium level. Gently scramble the egg properly or else the egg will just mess with the stew and it will not scramble well. I hope I'm clear here. So take your time, do this gently, beautifully, patiently, okay? If you really want the egg to scramble properly in the stew, then do as I'm saying. Let the heat be not too high. Let it be on the low to medium level. And gently stir to scramble the egg nicely like this, okay? Take your time to get the best results. And we are there. We got the results I'm looking for. It's beautiful. Also, the aroma here is amazing. I'm so loving this. Wow. I cannot wait to finish the whole recipe. This is so top-notch. I love this. Again, I'll let it simmer for about 3 to 5 minutes. And then I'll go ahead and add my mushrooms. And there we go. Beautiful. Beautiful. As usual, you stir gently to combine nicely and beautifully together. Family, so far, if you're enjoying this video and it's helpful, please don't forget to like, share, comment, and recommend this channel to friends and families who may also like my recipes. And if you are new here, you are warmly welcome. I'd love to have you here, so please subscribe. Click on the bell button as well to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. And you never ever regret it. Wow, this smells so beautiful. Again, I'm going to leave it for about 3 to 5 minutes for it to simmer whilst the mushrooms break down a bit. So family, keep watching and go nowhere. Wow. So now I'm going to add my cooked mackerel. Wow, and I love them in chunks like this. So it's up to you to break it down more into pieces or you leave them like this in chunks. As always, you stir to combine so that the mackerel will also absorb or soak up some of the beautiful flavors of the egg stew base. Even after stirring, I'm going to let the stew simmer for about 2 to 3 minutes so that the mackerel can easily and properly absorb the flavors of the egg stew base. Wow, I love the beautiful aroma. This house smells amazing. It's heaven right here. And beautiful right here. I'm going ahead to add my baby spinach, and I didn't cut it as usual because the heat will eventually break the spinach down. Now stir to combine as we all would do normally. Just stir to combine beautifully, gently, and patiently. I'm not all done. I'm going ahead to add more of the spinach and kale because the saucepan is not that big enough to add all at once, okay? So I'm doing this in bits, gradually and in batches. Adding spinach or kale to your egg stew like this is similar to using contumery or taro leaves, okay? I don't know if you can imagine the flavors that I started building from the beginning by adding my salted fish or fermented fish to the zumi palm oil. Going on ahead to add my toro beef or salted beef and adding my aromatic natural seasonings like the aniseed, star aniseed, and the rest. Family, this is heaven right here. The stew is so flavorful, it's so packed with nutrients. You can just imagine, this is amazing. Wow. I'm going ahead to add my shrimp tablet. Usually I'll add my shrimp powder or prawns powder. But since I just want to change some things, today I'm adding shrimp tablet. Sometimes too, I add both. I add the shrimp tablet and then the shrimp powder at the same time in one recipe or in one stew. But today, I want to use only the shrimp tablet. I've added some nutmeg and wow, unbelievable, immaculate. Keep on stirring to combine everything nicely together. Make sure the seasonings is well distributed, okay? Spread the seasonings, let the salt, everything be spread evenly, okay? Wow, I'm loving this. So far, so good, so immaculate, perfecto. Everything is still on point. At this stage, you can go ahead and add salt to your taste and preference. Because of the fermented fish and the salted beef I used from the beginning, plus the shrimp tablet, it makes the salt content just so fine. So I'm not adding any proper salt. So family, we are at the final stage and I'm adding my cooked and peeled prawns. This time around, I'm not taking off the tail. If I can eat crab, then why can't I leave the tail on? So it's on and I'm going to eat it like this. But in my previous videos, you can clearly see that I always take the tails off. But today, yes, I want them on. So I'm using the big spoon to press the prawns down into the stew so that they can also absorb or soak some of the amazing flavors of the stew. So in about 3 to 5 minutes, family, I should be back. And wow, when it comes to taste, it's perfect. When it comes to salt content, it's checked. This is so beautiful. I cannot talk much. I'm dumbfounded, family. I'm so dumbfounded. Wow. Immaculate. What an amazing aroma. Now, about 90% of the water is dried out. The stew is so ready. And there are so many spinach stew recipes out there. My family, try this one and bring me the feedback. I'm not going to blow my own trumpet, but just give this a try. Bring me the feedback if you can and I really appreciate it. This is so on top. It's the best among the best. Thank you all for watching and I hope you've been inspired. Subscribe to join this amazing family if you are new and let's build this amazing family together. It's chop time. Yes, friend. Where are your plates? Let's enjoy. For more videos like this, kindly follow your girl on Instagram, on Facebook, like my Facebook page as well. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for us to build this amazing family together. Thank you all for watching and see you all again in my next video. Until then, stay blessed, stay safe, be good, take care, enjoy. Mwah. Bye y'all.